According to Miami-Dade Police.
You're going to give me your driver's license. Give me your driver's license, registration.
Listen closely.
If not, you will not be going to work today. Simple thing, man. This is how you guys get killed out here, man. Registration and insurance.
Say that again.
My God.
Did he just threaten him?
Say what you just said.
Registration and insurance. You don't want to give them to
me? Why we get killed? What we get killed for? Okay. Okay. You're going to be famous, though. You're going to be famous. Look at him. Got nothing on me. Pull me over and threaten to shoot me. Threaten to kill me. We're going to court, man.
So what you just saw was video recorded apparently in the Miami area by the driver, who is Gerardson Nicolas. He says he was pulled over for not wearing a seatbelt, which is a thing that you can be pulled over for. It doesn't seem like the sort of thing that to me that would immediately raise the situation to, I need to implicitly threaten the life of the person I've pulled over. But for the cop, it was enough. And Gerardson said in advance of the filming, he was scared. He said, as I was scared, I was scared. I didn't think my life was going to make it. So I don't know what the cop did initially to scare him so much, but he felt like he needed to record this. He said, when he asked me for my license, opened the door, I started recording. I was looking for my stuff, my license, because I didn't see my wallet. I was looking for my wallet and that wasn't my car. That was my mom's car and I didn't know where the registration was. I was looking, he got mad. And because I guess it took him a little bit of time to find the documents, the cop felt like he needed to opine on, this is why you all get killed in these situations. Because you take too long to get your documents, because you don't comply fast enough with my expectations that I would not put onto a different sort of driver. If I pulled over a white driver and they took a minute to find their license, I wouldn't immediately lose my mind. This is the sort of situation, Alonzo, where thank God he was recording, because nobody would have believed Gerardson if he hadn't had the footage of the cop saying that.
Well, this is another situation, John, where the recordings don't matter. We've seen the recordings, right? We've seen police shoot people, unarmed black people, you know, and that didn't matter. So for this cop to say this, I hate to say it, but he's being honest. He's like, yeah, this is why we shoot black people, because they don't have their license and registration handy the moment I ask for it. Like, that cop actually told the truth in that moment, you know. Last week or the week before, there was a video about this cop talking to a black person who they had a similar medical situation. I don't remember if it was their heart or it was something like that. And he prayed with them and all. And it was like, wow, look, a good cop. And it's like, okay, back to normal.
Yeah.
Here we are, back to normal. Just in case you thought something had changed. No. Here I am telling you. And he's being honest. He's telling the truth. This is why we kill you. See, what happens is you don't have your license handy. You're in your mom's car, so you're not sure where the registration is. Then you reach for the registration and I shoot you. And then I'll say that you had, oh, I don't know, a sandwich or a cell phone or something that looked like a gun. So I had to kill you. And then we would move on. So the cop was, this is probably the most truthful cop you're ever going to see. You know, this is why we kill you. Yeah, he's telling the truth.
Because of a mild inconvenience. Well, I would add a little bit of context to this cop, because he seems to get that him being just inconvenienced a bit brings him to the level where he's ready to take a person's life. But I would also add that he should acknowledge that he has been he's been trained in law enforcement in America, a system where you're trained to always be terrified at any given second that your life could be taken. It doesn't matter how unlikely that is, doesn't matter if there's a weapon present. Anyone who's near you, especially a black person, can and will take your life with their bare hands at a second's notice. That's gonna happen. And if anyone even were to touch you, that would be the worst thing ever. So kill someone at the first opportunity. So they're trained to do that. They're trained to be terrified and to believe that their fear is a justification enough for murder. So that's true. They're also raised in a social setting in terms of pop culture, political conversations, all of that, where they are trained to be terrified at all times of black people, constantly, always, to also believe that black people are older, more competent, more prone to violence than anyone else. They don't need any social or physical cues of that. They're just trained to see it where it doesn't exist. And so when you combine all of these different things, the fact that they have personality characteristics that make them predisposed to violence if they believe that someone is defying their authority, where they're trained to always be afraid and to believe that the only way to allay your fear is to kill whatever's making you afraid, and to be predisposed to believe that certain types of people based on race and class and things like that are more likely to be violent, you make that stew and you get a lot of needless cop murders. I would add that to the cop's understanding of the situation, but he does seem to get how important it is to not frustrate him, Alonzo. That's true. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.